All right, let's have a talk about the three features on the 2021 R2 release. One of the really familiar ones, I think I really like this new feature, although everyone seems to be quite familiar with that already, which is the Explore cell. Because actually you have enhanced the visibility of that window. Let's go and take a look. As we all know from a sheet or a report, we can then go and try and call up the Explore cell window. Now I'm going to a working budget here. And what I'm going to do is we'll select one of the data cell, right click, Explore cell. As we all know that this popped up used to just list all the contribute levels or contribute accounts in full without a suppress zero. But now what you can see is everyone's defaults kind of in this window, it's suppressed rows, if zeros or blanks, which is clean up all the other contributed levels or elements, which there is no data, certainly much cleaner. So just unchecked and take a look at what you used to like is you've got a long list of all the zeros. So I think this feature is pretty good. And also with the Explore cell window, they've now rearranged the data and organized it better. On the left-hand side, you can see the value, which is aligned with that, the data source you are driving to. And then if you got due to transaction, you should be able to see in here as well and view audit trail where you can click into the link and get more details. And it also show you where the data is coming from, which is available sheets for the data. And on the right-hand side, now they organize all the description of the accounts that where the code is at the type of account. So it, whether it's an input account or a link account, et cetera. So it's more visible and more noticeable where the data is coming from. Any of the blue hyperlinked, you can actually drill into. I'm just clicking that to suppress zero. So it's certainly a lot cleaner. So from the bottom hand, if you drill into further, you can actually run through the data and see where the original data is coming from. With the multi-dimensions, you actually can juice through each of the dimension and get to the end of where the data is coming from. It depends on the number of the data and the number of dimension. You can actually go to a bit long path before you can get to the end of the calculation of the data or the input of the data. So in this case, the data is actually coming from a calculation. So if I click into the formula, I can then see this is the source sheets where the data is coming from. You can actually click to juice through to the sheets if you want to investigate further. So yeah, Explore cell is always a good feature for us to find out where the data is coming from and where the calculation is. And then although this feature is actually default to all user, but yeah, just in case there any customer doesn't like it to be default, Adaptive actually have created this access for us that if you opt out this function for this release, that you can actually do that. So it's sitting under administrations, visual preferences. And there is a checkbox for you to deselect and opt out if you want to. And by the way, the other two new release user interface features also available to be switched off if you don't like the new look of the sheet overview, which is this window. This new overview window have grouped the level assigned sheets and the assumption sheets together to make it more visible for user. But just in case, if you don't like it, you can also opt out. Just a quick mention on that, this window have actually increased the visibility of workflow status. If any of our customers have used that, you can now see that being more obvious which one is in progress, which one is locked or submitted. All right, so that covers the first feature of export cell. Let's move on to talk about the required columns of model sheets. So with the model sheets, if we get to the model sheet design, model management, and then I'll just select one of the model sheet we have. For example, customer database. So how you get to enable the setting is you go to the columns and the level settings. So in there, any of the one, the columns with the dimension, you can actually enable that to be required columns. So you will see when you click into a particular dimension, there is a settings here you can tick to make it a required columns. So just a reminder, if you do select a particular dimension to be a required column, and you need to make sure that you deselect the read-only options, because yeah, if it's read-only, that means the user can't really input into that columns. Once you enable that as a required column from the front end of that sheets, we can have a look at that. Customer database. You will be able to see that the market segment that I've enabled as a compulsory field actually have got an asterisk next to it. So if you have empty that particular cells or fields, you will notice that it's now reminding you you need to populate the required cell. So without putting any values in there, you can't really make a save on the data until you actually filled in this information. So what is handy is that, yeah, we did in the past have a lot of customer queries that can I make certain columns compulsory? So here we go, that Adaptive have made this happen. And so with these required columns, it also impacts how you import the data. So if you import data instead of directly input, when you go to the integrations, import data, you will notice the required columns is also indicate in the templates. So say, for example, we're uploading the model sheet information. We'll go and select customer database, which is the model sheet I've selected. So if you download that template, actually pop up on my side. So you notice in that required sessions, market segment is now a required columns. Without be able to fill data in, then you will come across with import error. So that's the consistency between direct input and manual imports. And again, if the customer is using the integration loader, you will also get similar idea. In the loader, that column that we have made as a required column need to be mapped. So it's, yeah, so this is an example. So in that column mapping, you will be able to just map the data. And then if you don't do that, then you will come up with an import error. So yeah, this actually concluded the second feature. The last feature is erase data. So with the erase data, actually sounds a bit scary because yeah, erase data means data lost. And yeah, so I had to explain that erase data don't usually go and use by itself. It usually use in conjunction of data upload. And just imagine if we're loading data into the system and then to clear what it was there before to make it clean, that erase data is the the function to come across with the uploads. So for a user to have that accessed, basically the admin user had to give the user the permissions. So with the customer who have turned on the access rule, please be aware the access rule doesn't apply and restrict the user ability to erase data. So that means if a user have the access to erase data, they actually can actually erase all levels or accounts without any limitation. So just be careful about how you assign that erase data function to user. So in terms of that, how we actually assign that access is to go to the permission sets. So for the user who usually have access to the erase data, I think most of customer probably would just leave this with the admin user. So we will see that access in the import capability sessions, so that you had to tick import to all levels before you can tick erase data. So that means the whoever user have access to erase data need to have the ability to import to all locations. That means, yeah, there are no data restrictions before they can erase data. I hope that makes sense. So in terms of the other settings that you need to turn on erase data feature is under the administrations, under the general setup. So in the enable feature sessions, you will be able to see this enable integration loader erase data. You need to tick this box if you need to use the erase data on the integration loaders. What we usually recommend is yes, you should have it tick because that's the integrations which is aligned with the erase data function. So if we go and have a look at the menu erase data feature. So that actually comes with when you do manual uploads. So yeah, if you do manual import data to erase data, you then have to go into the erase data menu because the import data doesn't automatically erase the same data set where you are importing to. So to clean up what was there before you load it, what you can do is you come to this erase data window. Some of the customer might remember that erase data used to call erase actual. So what it means is now it's renamed. It means the customer can now erase not just the actual version, but also any of the unlocked plan versions. So you will see a big warning message here and says, this will erase numerical data in a specific strata. So these are all the intersections we need to consider before we actually click the erase data button. So I think the good practice guide is to, you need to design the data set, select the scope of the data you would like to erase before you actually go ahead and erase, because once the data is gone, if you're not loading the same data sets, you might have got unexpected data loss on that. So yeah. So let's take a look at all these settings you need to choose. So first of all, choose the version. So define whether it's an actual or a particular plan versions. So for example, if I select actuals, it only limits to erase data on that actual versions. With the accounts, there are different account sets here. This one is all GR accounts. So that one is all custom accounts. This is a selected cube account. And then here is the cube sheet you need to select. So all these top three, it's all account. But if you don't want to erase all of them, what you can do is that you can do a definition or the parameter and then do a select specific and click a particular account that you want to erase so that you can narrow down the scope of erased data. And again, for the period to erase, you can choose a particular period or you can select a range of that. And then with the levels, depends on the level of data you're loading, you select all levels or go and select a particular levels. And this option is to include the stealth notes or not. So once all these elements are defined, and then you can do that erase data button. And with the warnings there, it's just saying if you select a parent levels or a row up account or a row up levels, the erase data feature will roll down to the children's. So this is the manual erase data feature. So once you erase data, then you can go ahead and do the import data, which is the same process that you usually use. And then the other one I would like to talk about is when it comes to erase data on an integration loader, what you need to be careful about is to set up that it's now seeing in the second tab of the integration loader. So if you click that, with the feature we turn on the general setup, so which is enabled the erase settings in the integration loader. So you need to tick that box, because I think default is like that. And when you tick it, you need to run through and track all of the selection is matching the import criteria. So usually the version parameter and the period parameter will be the same as how you actually set up in the integration loader. So matching that selection and that selection there. And then what we need to be careful about is in terms of the accounts and the levels, we need to make sure and only select whatever data we're loading to. Say if we're loading to standard sheets for all the GLs, that we can tick that box, or a particular custom account, so we can tick all custom accounts, or we can define the parameter. One thing I would like to point out, it's not that obvious where the parameter can be set up. So if you go into left-hand side where you got this edit parameter, you can actually define a parameter for your erase data feature. So usually we'll say we select a parameter which is shared by the entire instance. So click that and then you can add these new ones there, erase account and erase levels. That's a parameter you can define for a particular loader. So if you want to be more specific for each loader, you can actually name it based on the particular loader as well. And then with that, give it a name. And then you can also select the number of accounts that a particular account you can select to erase when you are loading the data. So you can select a number of them, or you can select the roll up of a parent. I hope that makes sense. Once you make the change and you can apply it and make a save of this parameter, then you can choose when you're doing the loader. I think that concluded the last feature of erase data. So let's have a look at whether there is any questions.